Objective computing is a recent research domain which aims to bridge a gap between human emotions and computational technology. The aim of affective computing is to make the machines able to recognize our emotions and to respond to it in an appropriate way. There are two complementary interests in affective computing. The first one corresponds to fundamental research, where we try to better understand relationships between perceptive cues such as facial expressions, speech behaviors, and some specific emotions. On the second side, we can integrate this technology into systems that can use affective computing to provide a more user-friendly interaction between humans and machines. There are several challenges in affective computing. One of them concerns the definition of the emotion itself, because the perception of emotion can be very subjective. The second challenge concerns the extraction of information from speech or facial behavior that is highly relevant to emotions while having very few variations between people.
We are working for quite a long time, about 10 years, on meeting analysis and producing some meeting tools to replay meetings or to assist people during meetings. What you lose in remote meetings is the understanding, awareness of the emotion of people that are remote. And this is particularly important in intercultural settings. So the emotiboard is actually enriching the video conference with some emotional feedback of the meeting participants.
The goal of emotiboard is to try to compensate some lack of information where we are working in remote interactions. There is a lack of emotion awareness because we are not in co-presence. The technology can try to recognize the emotions and display this as a feedback. There are different technology tools used in emotiboard. One concerns a database that we use to perform emotion recognition in real time. It's a kind of dictionary of specific behaviors in speech and facial expressions with their corresponding emotion. And we use that corpus to recognize in real time the emotion produced by the people. A second tool concerns the visualization of the information, because when we know which emotion has been produced, it is not really easy to know the best way to represent this information. We optimize the performance of the automatic emotion recognition system by analysis of existing databases. Then, when a system performs well enough, we integrate this tool in a real setup to see whether it can be enhanced further for remote interaction. Currently, we're looking into making the automatic emotion recognition more reliable for various recording conditions and people from different age, gender, and cultural backgrounds. We're also investigating an appropriate manner to represent an emotion as a feedback, because it has to be understood very well in a short amount of time to not interfere with the communications. This research allows us to better understand how human emotions are encoded during spontaneous interactions, which in turn can give machines the ability to understand human affective behavior and to know how to react to it.